Welcome, bienvenue. We're going to do everything in French tonight because I've realized the crowd is mostly French. Where do you guys normally hide? Too high. So we've got a rather small, intimate crowd today, probably because I kept on changing the date, but that happens. Merde happens, as they say. So thanks for coming tonight. We're going to talk a little bit about the Pearl River Delta. But before that, I just want to tell you about some funky prizes that we've got. Actually, before that, you can pick up one of these. This is a little guidebook that JJ has put together. So if you're looking for something to do in the Pearl River Delta, pick up one of these. It will go digital soon, right?
Of course.
Of course. And Jessica, are you here, Jessica? Jessica came up to me and she says, is it all right to hand these out? She's looking for a Ruby on Rails developer. I think tonight that the geek tech crowd are not here. Any Ruby on Rails guys here? There's one. Yeah, put your hand up again. Hand up again. Jessica, hand up. Could you go and give her a kiss? Yeah, nice. Thanks. It's called dating. She's looking for somebody. Rackspace, our faithful sponsor. Jim, are you here? Jim, do you want to tell us what you're looking for?
Sales and marketing.
Sales and marketing.
We can sell and market hosting. We want you.
There you go. Rackspace. Publicly listed companies. Then, do you give shares?
If you're good enough.
If you're good enough. All right, so Rackspace. So we've got some good prizes. JJ has brought, where are they? Over there. We're going to promote Zhuhai tonight. Maybe that's why there's not so many people. You're all over in Macau. But we're going to promote Zhuhai. Who's been to Zhuhai before? Who comes from Zhuhai? Patrick? So if you've been to Zhuhai, put your hand up if you go back again. Me. All right. So we've got some prizes tonight. We're giving out lunch for two at a very fancy new Mediterranean restaurant called Azure, and also a concert that we'll tell you about later, and then the top prize is a nice stay in the Holiday Inn in Zhuhai. So I've stayed in Zhuhai. Who's stayed in the Holiday Inn before? Nah. So now you know something to worthwhile winning. So let's get into our speaker, who's lost the prize. Oh, merde. So let's start. So Jean-Jacques. Do you like to be called Jean-Jacques or JJ?
Both Jean-Jacques and JJ fine, yeah.
So I met Jean-Jacques at my birthday party, and he told me that he runs a website. So tell us, what is this website? Okay, the first question I have is, why is a Frenchman running a website in English in China? Could you not be a Chinaman running a website in French in England? Or,
The reason why we chose English for the language of our website, obviously not enough French people in China, I'm afraid, yes. And not enough French-speaking people in China.
So how did you end up running a website? What's your history?
It's a long story, yeah?
Okay, 3 minutes.
3 minutes, good.
The crowd gets anxious.
I came to China for an educational project. I was asked to set up a French school in the city of Zhuhai. A language school with a French department. The idea was to try to develop the education with non-English languages. Nothing against our English friends, but there were already many schools teaching English. And my Chinese partner at that time had this good idea, I think, to try to explore another side of the market for education. So we set up a French department, then a German department, then a Korean department, then a Japanese department. And as we were doing this, that was 10 years ago, sorry, and there were very few foreigners living in Zhuhai or anywhere in China at that time. But as we were developing the school, more and more foreigners started to set up their companies in the mainland, and so there was an increasing need for them to learn Chinese. So we also had to set up, that was the logical development, to set up a Chinese department. And to promote the Chinese department, we had the idea to make a very simple website with some basic English information, because there's nothing at that time at all in English available online. to attract the people to join us for learning Chinese. And it worked even better than what we expected, especially the media part worked better than what we expected, and took over the education project. 3 minutes.
He's good. So, it's all right, so that was more interesting than I thought. So, it would be. But now my English is getting worse. I've been in Hong Kong too long.
You've seen what I've done with my class before.
So, okay, so you were here, you were in Zhuhai to teach, and then you decided, the internet is attracting people to this Chinese language thing. So how does that convert into Delta Bridges?
Well, I don't get the connection. When we had this website to promote our own language school, I had some people who asked me if they could place an advertisement on the site because it was starting to become popular. And so that was when I realized there's also a great need for information in China. Not because everything was blocked at that time, but just because there was nothing in English at all.
And so if you were living in Zhuhai, in what, 97?
The year 2000.
2000. How would you find out what's going on in the Pearl River Delta?
You couldn't, if you had friends, I would tell you what was going on, yeah.
So when did you set up Delta Bridges?
We set up Delta Bridges only 3 years ago, because it's like I said, it's a long story. I made it very short for you before. And it took several attempts before we could finally do it. It wasn't a straight success, as we call it.
So what happened after the school?
After the school, we set up. We did try to set up with some friends a website, but it didn't kind of work out because my partners, who were in charge of the IT, left. So I was. I found myself with a website that I couldn't do anything with.
And I bet you a few of the guys in this room have that experience, don't you? Don't you, Matt? Anybody have any experience building a website and then your partners go? No.
It's not very
shy.
It's just shy, Matt. Don't be shy.
So Delta Bridges. How did that start? I'm very curious. How did you set up? Why is it like? Did you look at Asia Expat and you go, oh, bonne idée?
I didn't look at Asia Expat. I probably looked at Shenzhen Party doing so well in Shenzhen, and I thought, well, Zhuhai is smaller. If I want to be able to compete with them, I may need to go beyond the Zhuhai. And because I was personally based half in Macau and half in Zhuhai, and already on my Zhuhai website, I already had to put more and more information about Macau. Because it was necessary, because people do travel a lot between the two cities. So then I met my actual partner, who was based in Zhongshan, and he wanted to do something in the media industries in Zhongshan. And then I thought, well, Zhongshan, Macau, Zhuhai, we might as well do something for the whole Pearl River Delta.
Your partner's here, right, Patrick?
This is another partner.
Hi, Patrick.
This is my partner, Patrick, there.
Patrick is very creative. He only has the word Patrick on his name card. You're hiding something. So you met your partner?
No. So from Zhuhai to Macau to Zhongshan, and we decided we might as well try to conquer the whole Pearl River Delta. And the way we've done it, to do media in mainland China, I'm sure Brent knows about this, it's very sensitive, so you have to be careful. We have to make sure that local government in each city support what we do. So our strategy, rather than to invade the market in one time, I call it the Mao Zedong Long March. We do one city by one city, by one village, and after village.
Do you kill people along the way?
Competitors.
You kill them?
Competitors try to kill us.
Okay. So we
are very nice. We don't kill anybody.
So your audience is expats, or are you finding that you're also getting a lot of Chinese who want to read stuff in English, or your audience?
The target audience when we started was expats, and the actual audience now, I would say, is nearly half-half, because there are more and more Chinese people who can speak and read English, and also they want to get English information. It's something that they are looking for.
But how do you find all the content? Is it like lots of stringers in different cities who update stuff? How do you keep it updated? Because obviously, if you've got, how many cities do you have now?
We cover 11 cities in the Pearl River Delta.
11 cities?
Yeah.
Including Hong Kong?
Including, but excluding Hong Kong, yeah.
That sounded like French. Can you translate?
No, in my mind, Hong Kong is already very well covered in terms of media and information, and it's a big city. We prefer to target smaller cities than Hong Kong. However, we think Hong Kong is still part of our plan because we believe sooner or later you will want to travel more and more in the Pearl River Delta for your business, for fun, for discovering China, whatever. So we believe Hong Kong as a distribution place and as a readership place, but not reporting on Hong Kong.
So are your...
It really means including, but excluding Hong Kong, right?
It's kind of.
Yeah. It's French.
So I still don't understand how you get content on your websites. Do you have lots of...
We have lots of editors, full-time editors, part-time editors, interns, a lot of people, co-operators.
Are you like Huffington, that you don't pay them and then you're going to sell it to somebody for lots of money?
Some people we pay, some people we don't pay.
That's cool.
English people we tend not to pay.
I don't pay English people either. Not in money anyway. So, usually beers, good enough. So, are you making money from the advertising? You said that people advertise, so I'm just curious. Is it like hotels coming to you and saying, oh, I want to advertise my restaurant? Or is it more sophisticated than that?
It's a lot of work before people come and call you. We have to knock on many people's door, but we find out that when we knock on people's door, usually it doesn't come. We cannot make a deal out of it. However, when the people contact us, then it works. It's easier because then they are looking for advertising, especially in mainland China, where they still believe that they don't need marketing and anything like that. They don't have very strong marketing departments, even big groups. So it's easier when they knock at our door. But still, it takes a lot of work and effort to do it, yeah.
But do you go to like ad networks and you sell to ad networks? So you've got like a sales team or is it just you?
We have a sales team, not a very big one, because it's difficult to find good salespeople. And if anybody's good at sales here, they can also get shares of our company. But
so you're competing in Rackspace, right? they're public listed. How much are you worth now? How many billions?
5 billion,
nothing. 50 billion, right? Be ambitious. So, okay, but did you need to get a license? I mean, you're doing content in English in China. Did you have to get a special license, the ICP license, or because it's in English, can you bypass the regulations?
No, we did bypass the regulations by using the one country, two system. So our media activities are based in Macau. Our marketing, advertising company is based in Zhuhai. So basically, the website, the little city guides that we print, all this officially is from Macau. But we have an entity in China which is officially allowed to sell advertising. So we kind of managed to find a loop in the law. But also, we don't do anything political, and we work very closely with the local government. So we get the support.
But on your website, you started off as a guide, right?
Yeah.
And now you have forums. So if you go into the forum space, that's very sensitive because you're allowing anybody to come in and say whatever they want to. So how do you control people going in there and saying, I love Ai Weiwei, free Ai Weiwei? How do you get around that?
This is the most difficult part of our job, of course, because we don't like to be censors, and where I come from, where you come from, we don't have to do this. But in China, we have to take care very closely at the forums. Luckily, I think the Delta Bridges field is more of a useful platform. So the question that people ask is, where can I buy this for my cat? Where can I do this? How can I invest my money there? It's not too much political. So it is nearly never happens that we have a political debate.
Excuse me. Hey. Shh. Tais-toi.
Censorship.
Tais-toi. Ta gueule, as they say in French. Thank you. Just, you know, a little bit of tension. I know he's from Zhuhai and he's French, but, you know, it's an interesting project he's got. So if I go to Delta, why would I want to go to Delta Bridges? What am I going to find? I'm living in Hong Kong, and in fact, I'm going to Dongguan tomorrow. So why would I want to go to Delta Bridges? What are you going to give me that I would want?
Why are you going to Dongguan for?
Huawei, a big Chinese telecoms company.
Wants to make business with you, yeah?
Wants to make a business with me.
Good.
Having a big dinner. So why would I want to go? How would I use Delta Bridges?
Are you going to come back straight to Hong Kong, or are you going to stay the night in Dongguan? Maybe after the meeting you want to go for a drink. Maybe you haven't chosen your hotel yet. Stuff like that.
So is it becoming a travel guide? I mean, this is where I'm a little bit confused. Is it a travel guide, or is it a business guide?
Or is it a networking, social network?
It's a bit of both. I understand that the concept may be confusing at the beginning. We're definitely not a travel guide, because who we target is not the people who go for one time in Dongguan. I think they can find better information in Lonely Planet or things like this. We target frequent business travelers. So we believe that all the 11 cities in the Pearl River Delta, they're already close, but they're getting closer and closer. The mainland China government is spending a lot of money to develop the transportation infrastructure. And I think any business person here will want to get more business in these neighboring cities, especially it's the richest part of China. So there is a lot of cash there. So my idea is more to help these business people who need to travel frequently to these cities. So between a business guide and between a travel guide. But definitely not a travel guide, though.
No, that's interesting. So tell us about the networking, because I understand that you're starting to do networking events.
Sure.
Because I know when people, you know, foreigners living in China get a little bit lonely, and they like to kind of hang out and meet other foreigners. So what are you doing on the networking side? I think that's an interesting...
The networking is mostly based in Macau. I believe that events can really support media as well as media can support events. And Macau was a little bit more difficult market for us because not as well as covered as Hong Kong, but still quite a few well-established existing media companies in Macau. So in order to compete with them, and to get the visibility that we needed in Macau, we thought the best way is to organize networking events. And I think we've done quite well in this.
So who would compete with you in Macau? Is it the...
There's a group called Ignite Group. They're very strong and powerful and mighty powerful.
So you set up networking. What are the events that you've got going in Macau? Is it like Web Wednesday, where you get some really annoying people at the back who don't stop talking? Or is it a little quieter and
we do,
is
we
it
do
Portuguese?
Not only the Portuguese, though. We do two events. One is called Delta Interchamber Event. The abbreviation is DICE, so we thought it was funny because Macau is a casino place. So.
Is the website DICE....
It's not DICE, it's Delta
Interchamber. DICE.MO? What is the Macau dot...
Nobody's allowed to get DICE.MO tonight.
DICE.MO. I'm bidding for DICE.MO.
No, it's called deltainterchamber.com.
M-O.
And we get people from Hong Kong coming there, from Guangdong and from Macau. It takes place every 3 months. In theory, you should belong to a chamber of commerce to be able to attend. But it's only the beginning. It's only the third event that we've done, so we're still flexible for that. So even if you're not a member, we may accept you.
So, okay, so I went to your website. Who has been to deltabridges.com here? Did you like it? Was it useful? Keep your hand up if you thought it was useful. A half hand. Why was it only half?
I didn't have time to explore it so much. But it was a bit overwhelming.
He was in a rush. So, okay. One question I have is, there's no social media element to your website, right? I know you started it probably very entrepreneurially, cheap. And did you build it yourself or did you have a...
I built it myself, yeah. The actual platform I did myself.
Excellent. Yeah. Good on you. Because there's a couple of people here tonight who want to build websites. Where are you? Who's looking to build a website? Where's that stockbroker chip? Yeah, put your hand up. There's a couple of you looking to build a website. Come and talk to him. Do it yourself first. DIY version.
Best way ever.
So how come on your website there's no kind of social media sharing? Is it because you're in China and it's all blocked, or is it because you're not linking, your audience doesn't use the Chinese social media? Why?
No, of course, we would love to use the social networking tools. We think they are very, very important and essential for any business these days. And the main and only reason why we don't do it is because they're all blocked in China. And we operate in China. Most of our users are from China. And we haven't found a system yet so that Hong Kong people could use it, but not the mainland China people could use it.
So that's interesting. You're saying most of your users are based in China. So it's
sure.
It's people in China who want to know about Macau, who want to know about Zhubei.
Sure.
It's not people coming on a business trip who are going to the Canton Fair and they want to go and visit some factories in the Pearl River Delta and they want to find out.
Of course, we have quite a good Google referencing, so these people find us, but I think... They look what they are looking. They search for the information they look for, and they are not regular visitors, I guess. And of course, we have people like that as well. But still, I believe that if we implement the social networking tools on our website, it should work for everybody. And at the moment, you have an ugly little box with this page not available, you know, if you are using internet without a VPN system in China. So
that's quite interesting, as most people who come here talk about social media and how wonderful it is, but to have somebody who's challenged by it is quite unusual. So do you have a database? I mean, do people subscribe? Are you building up a membership? Is your plan to have like the Delta Bridges credit card, or what is your idea in terms of building up the community?
We do give in the little guides a VIP card that entitles people for benefits. But the number one way for us to get the database is through our newsletter system, because there is a strong need for foreigners to get information, so people tend to subscribe quite easily to newsletters. And we have over 40...
So why don't you launch like a Groupon of Delta, of the Pearl River Delta? Delta On. A Groupon.
A Groupon?
Like a discount. You could have a discount for restaurants in
we, the... We do. The people who get the card there...
So, all right. So you've got a website. You've got this. How about mobile stuff? Are you? Everybody's getting very excited about iPads. Do you have any content that's available on a phone or a?
This is our plan for 2011. We want to develop iPhone and iPad applications for content for all these cities. We have a huge directory on our website. I think it's several thousand restaurants and bars and stuff like that. And this is the aim to implement it in the iPhone application, yeah.
Any app developers here? No, I told you the geeks are not here tonight. The geeks are hidden. The geeks are in hiding tonight. Don't know what's going on. So, how about, do you buy traffic? Because you're a site, do you go and buy ads on Google? Do you buy ads on Baidu? Do you believe in buying traffic, or is all, do you want people to find you because their friend suggested you, or how, word of mouth? Or do you, as an owner of a website, do you believe in buying traffic? Do you believe in paying for advertising?
I believe in, of course, I believe in people buying stuff for advertising. That's why they can buy ads on our platform. But in our case now, we are in the process of launching, we have kind of launched, but not done the promotion yet. We're going to develop a service branch to our media activities. And when that's ready, for sure I will buy advertisement to promote that. At the moment, I'm a bit reluctant to pay advertising for a user to come to my website, because that user is not directly going to generate income to me. They will, but it will take a long time before that income...
Depends how much you sell your advertising for.
Sure.
But... Okay. Any questions from the floor? I have some more questions. Anybody got a question? I can't see this light, it's so bright. Anybody have a question? Put your hand up. If you don't be shy, you can even say it in French, Nicolas.
What is your hello, Nicolas from AFP. What is your current audience, and how did you reach this number as of today? Because you said you didn't buy audience. Yes.
We the number one audience we have is we have over 40,000 subscribers to our newsletter who are the Pearl River Delta. We get about 100,000 page visits per month. And how did we get it? I think we have a good SEO system on our website. We have fairly good Google referencing, and I think that's probably the number one thing that helped us. And secondly, I think the events, and especially the networking events. I mean, one event after the other, that has helped a lot.
So tell us about the music side. You're involved in jazz and in the Beishan World Music Festival. Tell us a little bit about that.
So in Macau, we do business networking events, and on the other side of the border in Zhuhai, we looked at what was missing and what could interest the our Chinese fans. The idea of Delta Bridges is try to conquer little by little the Chinese market. And so to do a business networking event in English, that would not be suitable. But one thing which is not happening in many cities in China is cultural activities. The government, they have a great budget to do that, but they don't have the expertise yet. So I have a Chinese partner to do this, and we thought if we can implement ourselves and do something really good in Zhuhai, we could even sell these projects to the other cities, to the local governments. because Beijing, 6 months ago, the central government in Beijing said that Guangdong had to develop the cultural industries. So we heard that, and now
it's a bit like Hong Kong. We're trying to develop our creative industry.
Right? Cultural and creative industries, yeah. Well, we can help you.
So how does the jazz festival work? So you approach the government, or you like jazz? What was the history?
I personally like jazz, and my Chinese partner also like jazz. And years ago, we said that we were going to do something in jazz. In fact, it was a bit lucky because when we started this music festival, it wasn't intended to be jazz. We were thinking more rock music or mixed kind of music. And we met a guy from Hong Kong called Peter Lee, who runs the Hong Kong Jazz Association. And in one click, we could get 10 bands to come to Zhuhai on the same weekend. Something that we wouldn't have been able to do by ourselves. So from that on, we said, right, let's do jazz.
So the bands were foreign bands or Chinese bands?
All foreign bands, mostly foreign bands, maybe a couple Chinese bands, but mostly foreign bands. And they are touring in China. They are going to Shanghai.
Wow, you lot are really rowdy. Excuse me. Who's that? Is it Jay again? Venus. Five more minutes. I want to hear about music in Zhuhai. So you set up a festival.
So we do the jazz festival every year, October, and we do a world music festival every April.
So the world music festival is like kind of ethnic stuff, or is it world? It's not like...
It's ethnic stuff, but more than ethnic stuff. So you may have a couple electric guitars or so along with the ethnic, okay? It doesn't have to be purely ethnic, but it must be ethnic based.
I think it's interesting, because what you're saying is, in China now, the cities are competing with each other, right? The mayors of each city, they want to attract more tourists, more business, more investment. So do you go to the government and say, I have a website, I have a directory, I have a cultural event, pay me to help your city become established?
This is what we say, but we do it step by step. First, we need to do this project, I think, for 1 year, maybe two, before we can start selling them. It's a long-term project.
So how do the government officials react when you walk in? Do they give you dirty looks? Or
so
they quite
the first year, they give us the support in the sense that they will give us the authorization to do the event. Yeah. Already, this is very difficult to get. And maybe hopefully the second year, we'll get cash from them. That's what we want.
So are you making money now?
With the, both the media and the event, we're starting to become profitable here this year. Yeah.
That's cool. All right, any more questions? Before I do, we do have another question. Can you come up here? Come up here, don't be scared.
He's the one who said half.
I was, right, half not him, no. I was just wondering where you host your site. Do you use Rackspace?
So, look, I was hosting my website 3 years ago in Hong Kong, 4 years ago, 5 years ago, 3 years ago in Hong Kong, and frankly, the service was not very good. It was very difficult to find a decent company that could host the kind of website that we do, which is fairly big in size and active, and they're good for corporate sites, and don't take me wrong, but they really were not suitable for my needs, and I searched a lot and I couldn't find anything. So I thought it was a shame, because I always thought Hong Kong would be a perfect place for such company to be, because it's really the east, the west. Companies like me, I told you before, most of my users are based, regular users are based in China, but we get a lot of one-off users from America and Europe, so I need everybody to be able to access my site. So I was very disappointed, but 2.5 years ago when we moved to California. But we're coming back now, because we've discovered
Rackspace.
So we're coming back to Hong Kong.
I can't believe you moved from Hong Kong to California. Can you not use China Cash or one of those guys in China?
If your site gets hosted in China, sure you can. But if it's hosted in China, a local government can block your site. So that usually it's one guy. So if you meet him in a bar and he doesn't like you, you have an argument with him, the next day you can click on the button and you're blocked. If you host it outside of China, it's a centralized decision. So there's a committee and it's 20 people around the table and they decide which site they are going to block. So it's a bit more rational. If you're not doing anything against China on your site, you're probably not going to get blocked.
But I see. So
inside China is a bit dangerous, I think.
That's interesting. And what about mobile? Can I access? Is your site like accessible by mobile? Because I know in China now, there's about, I don't know, the numbers are huge, but there's I don't know the numbers, I'm sorry, but I think it's huge, the mobile access, right? What is it, 400 million access to mobile?
Something like that.
So do you get much mobile access? So people?
Yeah, we get more and more, of course, especially with iPhone and everything. iPhone's quite popular in China. And our site is accessible, so it works on iPhone. But we still want to do application because it's better.
And what, last question, what technology do you use? I mean, you built it yourself, right? But have you upgraded it? Are you using WordPress or Drupal?
Just we're using
for the one geek in the room. what technology are you hosting your website
for? My previous site, as I said, my partner who was in charge of the IT, I had to go back to his home country, so I was stuck with a website that I couldn't use. So when I decided to carry on in the website industry, I said, well, I need to learn and be able to do it by myself, at least to start with. And I was lucky, some of my friends recommended me different platforms. And more or less randomly, between these platforms, I chose Drupal, which I think Drupal, D-R-U...
Drupal, right. Brent, it's the same. Is Brent still here? Shenzhen Party.
It's based on Drupal.
Shenzhen Party is Drupal, right? CNN Go is Drupal.
Also.
CNN Go is Drupal. Anybody else got a website in Drupal? Does Rackspace host Drupal?
Absolutely. I
host
CNN Go.
CNN Go. Whoa! You need to host the bridges. Don't you? So Drupal.
So Drupal is
Drupal? Why did you not choose WordPress or Joomla or all these other funky things?
Like I said, it was a bit of a random choice at the time because I knew very little about IT, but I was lucky because out of all these platforms, I sincerely believe Drupal is the one that's developed the best and the fastest. The White House website is in Drupal. Most of the French news media is in Drupal now, and I'm sure it's the same for the other countries.
Nicolas, are you in Drupal? AFP is in Drupal?
Not yet.
What are you in? Are you in some old-fashioned...
Old-fashioned. HTML.
Excellent. Okay, well, any more questions?
But if you want to build your site, I really strongly recommend Drupal because it's something that you can use without any IT knowledge. You just need to learn how the CMS is working and you can do quite a lot with it. It's amazing.
It's open source, right?
It's open source.
Is Drupal, the way you say Drupal sounds very French. Is it a French... Is it a French technology?
It's from my neighbors from Holland.
Holland. Drupal. All right, guys. Thank you very much. Big round of applause for our guest.
Thank you.
And now we have the fancy lucky draw. Should we go down there? No, it's okay. Lucky draw. Come
down. Wait. I haven't put my card in.
Wait. Somebody wants to go to Zhuhai. Pia wants to go to Zhuhai. Who hasn't put their name card in? You want to win lunch in Zhuhai? A bit of culture in Zhuhai? Come here. All right, so the third prize is, what is it again? It's dinner at a restaurant called Azure, a very groovy, it's on my blog, go and visit webwednesday.asia. I put up, it's got a video of the founder, a very good friend of ours, and the chef. So it's lunch for two.
Lunch for two and two tickets for the World Music Festival, which is really quite good. Huh? We have Malaysian bands, Cuban bands, Xinjiang bands.
On when? What date?
It's on the Saturday, the 23rd of April, Easter weekend.
Okay, go for a bit of culture. We haven't got any culture in Hong Kong, so go to Zhuhai. All right. Lucky draw. The winner is... Ta-da.
Naomi Rebecca.
Naomi Rebecca. Two first names. Is that her name? Naomi Rebecca. Woohoo! Yay! Photograph! Here you go. Pose for the camera, please. Pose. There you go. Excellent. Thank you. Next.
You know where Zhuhai is, yeah?
I actually asked my friend earlier today, but yes, I know.
It's only a 45-minute boat ride from here. Actually, it's very nice, very green. All right, the second prize is...
The same.
Again, which is?
The luncheon for two in this beautiful restaurant called Azure, and also two tickets for you to join the World Music Festival.
Okay, lucky draw. Dig. And the winner is... I can see that card from here.
Jay
Oway. Are you Jay still Oway. Here? Jay, do you know what Zhuhai is? It's not far from Canada. Jay. The problem is you can't use Twitter in Zhuhai, so you might have to turn off for a while. Jay has 100,000 followers on Twitter. Who follows Jay on Twitter?
Thank you!
Oh, sorry, only six. Not all of you. Photo, photo, photo. Excellent. And the finale, the grand prize. Before I do the grand prize, I want to say one thing. The next Web Wednesday is on the first Wednesday. Thank God. Apologies for moving it around. I have a busy schedule, but they pay me, so that's all right. On May the 4th, we've got a guy called Gert Leonhard, who sounds like a warrior from the Viking days, but he's actually a media futurist. He's going to talk about the future of digital content. He's a smart guy, and he's a good speaker. And he's brought to you by Music Matters, and Digital Matters is... Are the Digital Matters people here? Music Matters? Can I see you? You there? They're gone. Anyway, he's going to be here, and he's a good speaker, so please come on May the 4th. Okay, final prize. Hotel, two hotel rooms.
Two hotel rooms in Zhuhai again, okay?
Two.
Yeah, two, in case the people are scared to go by themselves.
Zhuhai is scary. And the winner is?
David C. Pitt. David Pitt.
David Pitt. Going once, going twice. Woo-hoo! He looks like he needs two room nights in Zhuhai, so. There you go. Unfortunately, he's not going to give them to you. You're going to hold his name card. Photo, photo opportunity. Yeah, yeah, pretend. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Hold this, hold this, hold this, hold this. Yeah, photo.
Brilliant.
All right, thank you very much.
Sorry, yeah.
So, thank you. Please hang around for the next hour or so. Get to know each other. And we'll see you on May the 4th. Thank you. Thank you, Jay. Merci beaucoup.
Thank you.
interesting is that we are entering a second phase where the most foreigners, they little by little, they've heard of the VPN access. So they subscribe to a VPN and then $10 a month per year. And then Facebook and Twitter becomes alive again. Okay? You know, in our interest of doing things in China, I need to think twice before I implement Facebook and Twitter too much. Political reasons, because at the moment we are being tolerated to do a media activity in the mainland, and although I would benefit in terms of traffic from Facebook and Twitter, but what if I'm kicked out of China, you know, so it's still a dilemma for me whether to do it or not. You still need to wait a little bit. Frankly now, what I said today is partly untrue because of the VPN access. I could do something with Facebook now, and Twitter, and it would be good for me in terms of users and ranking and everything. But mainland China is mainland China. They're blocking Gmail now, for example, you know? What can we do? Yes, it is the agenda.
I'm very interested in hearing
this. Nice to meet you. We'll keep in touch. Have a day. Nice to meet you.
So, I was doing the same thing.
Oh, it's the agenda. Thank you.